$50 on my neck, know the $50,000 on my wrist.
What's good, YouTube? It's your boy CFN Cash. Welcome back to my channel. Y'all know, getting off in here. I'm back, and I'm not leaving again. You know, made a commitment to myself. You know, I'm finna start posting straight bangers in here. I'm trying to make it. You know, I'm doing big things now. Y'all see, no more using the phones. I'm rocking the whole Kane GX7. No, Kane G7X. Boy, I said it wrong. Yeah, I did say it wrong. But you already know how it is. You feel me? I'm back and I'm not leaving again. I've been missing for 5 months. I've been locked up for about 5 months. And that's what we're doing today. I'm doing a story time of me being locked up. And probably at the end, I'm going to answer some questions that people ask me. So let's get straight into it. All right, YouTube. So I'm going to start this off like it's my first day being locked up. My first day being locked up was hell. It was hell, man. I missed my family, I missed my girl, missed my so-called friends at school, you feel me? I missed it, everybody. So, basically, like my first day locked up, you know, I did cry. I'm like, damn, I'm really finna have to sit down here for 5 months. I knew I was gonna be here for five months, like, my damn, I'm finna miss 5 months. My girl, like, my brother's, like, my nephew, like, my mom's, like, shit crazy. And, like, I already knew what was gonna happen, you know. I already knew I was finna do that time. So, you know, did 4 days on iUnit. That was hell. You in your cell 23 hours out of the day and eat in your room, all that. Just sleep all day, basically. That's all you do. And then if you up, read a book, or then go back to sleep, or you just be up. It was dead. It was horrible. Every time I get my food and stuff, I get ready like to start crying and stuff. Every time I eat, I think about me being with my family, me being with my girl, me being with my nephew. You know, like, it was just messing me up. But all that changed after my first day on the block. I already knew like 7 people that was locked up, so. No, I already knew the rules, I already knew this, and I already fitted in, you feel me? And it was messed up. That time being there, it was hell. Like, stats was cool, I ain't gonna flip, but sometimes stats be on their periods. And you hoop every day. Just hoop. Lift weights. Like, I used to do push-ups, but I used to do my push-ups fast, like, you know, thinking I'm that nigga doing them push-ups real fast. No, was not doing shit, was not getting no muscles, none of that, not getting ripped, none of that. And I started like doing them slow, diamonds wide, getting my chest, not my chest out there. My arms is ripped, they don't like look big, but they ripped. They got bigger than what they was though, I'll tell y'all that. Used to lift weights, you know. It was horrible though. You know, I talked to my girl every day. I talked to my mom probably like once a week. About seeing my mom once a week. I usually call my mom on a Wednesday. Sometimes I ain't call. But I talk to my girl like every day though, for real. Making sure she alright. And a lot of the reason why, you know, I ain't call my mom every day because I see my mom. But I did call her. I'll call her at least Wednesday, and I'll see my mom Sunday. And I'll call my girl every day. And if I get extra phone calls, you know, I'll call my mom and my brothers and stuff. Sometimes they phone be off, like, they ringer be off, they don't be hearing the phone ring. I used to get mad. But, yeah, bro, I was in cell 19 when I first got there on 102 side. You know, whoever, if y'all in Fort Wayne, Indiana, y'all get locked up, look at B19. Y'all see CFN card on the door, you know, that's me. Then I got moved to B22 because my intercom didn't work. And I flooded. I took a huge dookie, like, and flooded my toilet, and my room was flooded. Tore that thing up. And then they moved me to B14. And I've been in New Area City for the rest of my time. I was in B14 for probably like 2.5 months. And I was in B22 for a month, and I was in B19 for like a month. So yeah, that's really how it was. Food, it depends who cook it. If Miss T, I swear to God, you a blessing. Whenever you cook, love your food. It's very, you can cook, but your stuff really ain't got that taste to it. You ain't got that power that Miss T got, you feel me? And Chad, bro, you need to quit your job. You can't cook for shit. I'm gonna tell you this now, like, I don't know why they hired you. I'm not trying to be funny, but you can't cook. You don't season your food. Meat be pink. I be wanting to throw up. Please stop. I forgot to tell you to quit before I left. You lucky. But that's how it is. When you in jail, you basically expect to get that shit done. But Miss T, you hooked us up. I swear to God, Thanksgiving was bomb. Christmas was bomb. You know, spaghetti was bomb. Them burgers, them thick burgers used to make bomb. Oh, my mom, you used to plug us. All right, but shoot, every day I probably read a book. You just used to read, get through my time, read my girl letters, look at her pictures, be in my cell all day. Used to just think about my past, you know. Just think about all the stuff I did, you know. I was trying to find God in there. Used to watch TV every day. Had my glasses. I broke my glasses in there, y'all. Look, I got them right here. I see you got them tape on them and stuff, you feel me? Could not go. Look. Broke the glasses. Then I got some new glasses. They say they some staff used to try to flame me and stuff. Say they was like some old man glasses and some rapist glasses or something. Try to climb me though. I ain't tripping. But I broke them glasses like 2 days before I left on accident. And then so now I'm really glassless because I'm not finna wear these in public. I mean that's up. So that's just how it is. And what else happened? Oh, I was just gonna tell y'all like the most time, like the worst time that I had in there where I almost lost it was when this dude Mac, you know, him and Tony. It's him, Tony. We know when they fought the staffs and stuff. And that was turned up. But I was so mad, bro. Like, I just wanted to fight the staff too. But I almost got out the wall. But I'm like, don't do it. I'm telling my man's Red, don't do it. Like, we tempted to get off the wall, just start swinging too. Like, it was just so messed up. Can't do nothing though. Or we gonna get more time, you feel me? So it was really messed up though, for real. But that was one of the worst times. And the other worst time was like, when me and my girl got into it, you know, I was tripping, you know. I was being locked up, you just trip. Just think of always negative shit. I can't stop myself from thinking of something negative, you feel me? Something that could happen, you feel me? You know, I brought that shit to her. She was shitty. I'm so stupid, bro. I was tripping, bro. You know, I love my little baby girl, I swear to God. Like, I probably would never got none of that shit if it wasn't for her. Like, she been there sending me letters. Her, literally, my girl sent me a letter probably twice a week. Not every week, but like when she did, it would be like two letters or something a week. She'll spray them down with perfume, have my room smelling good. I used to just sit there, walk out, go like this in front of people's face. Like, they used to be like, man, that shit smell good on my heel. Yeah, I know it smell good. Her and this girl VVS Diamond VK. She wrote me. Nobody else wrote me. Just them two. Don't talk to my brothers on the phone, you know, that's cool. But everybody else, no, nobody wrote me to check up on me, none of that. So when you locked up, you really find out who really fuck with you and who really don't. Some niggas just be there to be in your face. I don't fuck with nobody. I fuck with myself. Just me. I'm independent. Feel me? But you know, I used to have talks with the staffs. Phillips, boy, that's right. He annoying. This nigga. They all be getting to it. Right. Swear to God, this nigga look like Sada Baby and shit. I swear to God. The new staffs click. And Campbell, cool as hell, I swear to God. But Stevens, bro, this nigga, his breath stank. When I tell you his breath be on fire, like, he'll be standing there breathing when he opening the door for us. And then we walk past that, and it's just sitting there in the air, like, his breath just literally just sitting there in the air. You just smack straight into it. I used to tell him, bro, I'm like, bro, you need your hygiene. I swear to God, bro, you should not, your breath should not ever be smelling like that, bro. Like, I don't know if he got a rotten tooth or something, but he need to get that shit checked. And he used to, like, chew gums and mint and, like, red hot stuff, you know, with cinnamon to try to make his breath smell good. That shit did not work. I'll tell you right now, bro, that did not work. It's really not like a story time. It's, like, basically telling you, like, my experience being in there. So that's why I'm gonna name it. Scratch it off being a story time. I'm gonna make this my experience of being locked up for 5 months, part one. Feel me? Like that. CFN Cash Boy, we back. And I will be posting bangers. I got some people that I'm finna make some videos with. And this one video, I swear to God, it's gonna be so cold. And I'm telling this video gonna be the one that get me out of Fort Wayne, I promise you. You know, I'm finna make videos with my girl. I don't know, you know, cause these little chicken heads out here be jealous and stuff. And just be messy for no reason. Like, just petty as hell. Nobody pay attention to that, cause you know, me and my girl, we still good. Finna get a crib, you feel me? Finna go vacay, you feel me? All that, we good out here. Little ass girls need to go. Leave me alone. So yeah, y'all. I will do the part two of my experience, and that part is probably gonna be more talking about. I don't know. I'm probably just gonna talk about something that happened, like a situation that happened. Probably make it into a long. Probably situation. Cause I used to have this little book. Like it was a journal. I used to write in it. Like, tell shit, this how my day was, you feel me? This what happened today. You know, I learned how to shoot dice with cards in there. I learned how to play all these games in there. I've been learning how to play spades in there, but I learned how to play spades, all types of games. Tonk, casino, dice, solitaire, two-man solitaire. All types of games, Blu-ray, all that. So yeah, I love y'all. Thanks for watching this video. You know, just share it. You know, subscribe, like, comment, turn on notifications button. Like, you know, we trying to do big now. I'm trying to do big things. So you're gonna all right, YouTube. And I wanted to let y'all know. You know how we get like custom shirts made and stuff like that. I got this business partner I'm doing it with. But here we go right here. Let me see if it's focused real quick. Come on, focus. Here we go. Go hit them up on Facebook. Right there. And if y'all want shirts made, I'm gonna focus. Alright, if y'all want shirts made, just hit this Facebook up. Right here. Why don't I feel low? Oops. This Facebook up right here. And if you hit them up on the book, just send them the promotion code at CFN. You know, you get your little discounts all wide win. And if you want, like, my shirts getting made too, cause I'm getting, start my own little clothing thing with my little CFN right there, you feel me? So, if y'all want, like, shirts and y'all want to get shirts made, cuffs made, anything, just hit up this on the book for me. Put the promotion code down there. If y'all got questions, just hit me up on the Snap or Facebook or Instagram. All my links will be in the description down below. And I'm gonna put this Red Warrior creation links in the description too. So y'all make sure y'all hit them up. All right, peace out.
I don't go back and forth on the internet. Real niggas don't get in there. I'm trying to get in on my mouth, real. I'm trying to get in on my mouth. Me and my dogs, me and my dogs.